Welcome back, children. Today we'll do the second topic, that is how to separate cream from milk. Now you know that milk is a colloidal solution. You cannot separate the particles of fat, protein by simple filtration. So we apply a special technique which is called as centrifugation. Now in this technique, milk is taken in a cylindrical container and it is rotated very fast with a great speed. Then what happens? The denser particles settle at the bottom while the lighter particles, they come and float at the top. And in this way it can be separated. So in a centrifuge this is possible. The most common application of centrifugation is in washing machine, which many of you are having at home. In washing machine, the dryer section is the section of the washing machine which is used for drying clothes. What happens there? Wet clothes is kept in a cylinder with lot of holes. It is covered from the top with a lid, and then when you switch it on, it starts rotating at a great speed. When this happens, the water molecules, they fly off. They are thrown away from the wet cloth. So as the water is thrown away from the wet cloth, automatically the cloth becomes dry. So this is the most simple centrifuge machine which we use in our daily life. This way, for extracting butter from cream or cream from milk, all these things are done in dairies with the help of centrifugation. In diagnostic laboratories for removing the components of blood, again centrifugation is used. Similarly, for removing the components in urine, in pathological laboratory, centrifugation method is used. So in this way, by the use of centrifuge machine or by the process of centrifugation, we are able to separate the lighter components from its mixture with heavy components. Right, children? Now, after this, the third one that we will do is how to separate two immiscible liquids. Now to separate two immiscible liquids, like say oil and water, we use a separating funnel. A separating funnel is a conical apparatus which has a lid at the top and a tap at the bottom. So when you take the mixture of two immiscible liquids like oil and water in that separating funnel, you will find that the heavier liquid, which is water, it will settle at the bottom of the separating funnel, and the lighter liquid, means whose density is less, that is oil, it will be above. It will be above water, right? Because oil and water do not mix. So after the two layers has been formed, that is lower layer of water, above that layer is oil, you open the tap slowly, what you will find? That water gets drained out slowly. Now, when all the water has been drained out, you close the tap. So, as you close the tap, oil is unable to come out. So, oil remains in the separating funnel. Only water is drained out. Thus, we are able to separate the components of the mixture. In this way, we can separate the constituents of two immiscible liquids from each other. In our next class, we will continue with more methods of separation. Thank you.